The moral agent. A moral agent is a person who has the ability to discern right from wrong and to be held accountable for his or her own actions. Moral agents have a moral responsibility not to cause unjustified harm. Traditionally, moral agency is assigned only to those who can be held responsible for their actions. By expecting people to act as moral agents, we hold people accountable for the harm they cause others.
The six-stage model of moral development was composed by Lawrence Goldberg, a psychologist who studied the development of moral reasoning in individuals. According to Goldberg, moral development occurs in stages, with each stage representing a more advanced level of moral reasoning. Level 1, Preconventional Morality. Stage 1, Obedience and Punishment Orientation. At this stage, individuals are focused on avoiding punishment and obeying authority's figure. They are not concerned with the needs and perspective of others. Stage 2, Individualism and Exchange. At this stage, individuals begin to take into account the needs and perspectives of others, but their focus is still primarily on their own interests. They see morality as matter of equal exchange, and they believe that people should be fair to each other and their dealings. Level 2, Conventional Morality. Stage 3, Good Interpersonal Relationship. At this stage, individuals begin to value the opinions of and feelings of others. They want to be seen as a good person by those they care about, and they seek to maintain positive relationship. They are concerned with meeting the expectation of others. Stage 4, Maintaining the Social Orders. At this stage, individuals see the importance of upholding the social order and the rules they govern it. They believe that rules are necessary for maintaining a stable society, and they feel a sense of duty to follow them. They are concerned with the good of society as a whole. Level 3, Post-Conventional Morality. Stage 5, Social Contract and Individual Rights. At this stage, individuals recognize the rules and laws are not absolute, but rather the agreements among members of society. They see the importance of protecting individuals' rights and promoting their greatest good for the greatest number of people. Stage 6, Universal Principle. At this stage, individuals develop a sense of moral principle that transcends societal norms and laws. They have a strong commitment to justice and are willing to challenge laws and conventions that conflict with their principles. They are concerned with the principle of justice, equality, and human dignity.
Stage number 1, Respect for Power and Punishment. A young child age 1 to 5 chooses what to do, what is right, according to what he, she want to do and can do without getting into trouble. In this level, to be right and ought to be obedient to the people in power and thus avoid punishment. The motto in this stage seems to be, might makes right. Having the freedom to choose means that you have the ability and right to make your own decision and take action based on your own preferences, belief, and values. This includes choosing how you want to live your life, what goals you want to pursue, and what relationship you want to build. It also means that you can make choices about your education, career, hobbies, and lifestyle without being constrained by external forces such as social norms or cultural expectations. Ultimately, having the freedom to choose allows you to lead a more authentic and fulfilling life based on your own unique vision and aspiration. Stage 2, Looking Out for Number 1. Children aged 5 to 10 are disposed to be egotistic or self-serving. They lack respect for others' right but may give to others on the assumption that they will give as much or even more in return. Instead of loyalty, gratitude, or justice, the case is more a matter of you scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. The motto here seemed to be, what's in it for me? Stage 3. Being a good boy or nice girl. In this stage, people age 8 to 16 have shifted from pleasing themselves to pleasing important others, usually parents, teachers, or friends. They seek approval and thus conform to someone else's expectation. When charged of doing something wrong, their behavior is likely to be justified by stating, everyone else is doing it, or I didn't intend to hurt anyone. The motto here, I want to be nice. Pleasing others and pleasing oneself are two distinct concepts that relate to an individual's decision-making process and priorities. Pleasing others involves prioritizing the happiness and satisfaction of others over one's own, while pleasing oneself involves prioritizing one's own happiness and satisfaction over others. Stage 4. Law and order thinking. Here, the majority of people, 16 years old and older, have internalized society rules about how to behave. They feel indebted to conform, no longer to just family and friends, but also to society's law and customs. They realize that it is important to do one's duty to maintain social order. Social leaders are assumed to be right and social rules are adapted without considering that core moral principle involved. Thus, social control in this stage is exercised through guilt associated with breaking a rule, though the guilt in this case is an automatic emotional response, not a rational reaction of conscience based on moral principles. In this stage, individuals believe that anyone breaking the rule deserves to be punished and pay his or her debt to society. The motto here is, I'll do my duty. However, it is important to know that law and order thinking should not be the sole determinant or conscience based on moral decision making. Law and social norms are not always an accurate reflection of what is morality right or wrong. And it's important for individuals to critically evaluate established norms and law in light of their own personal values and belief. Stage 5. Justice through democracy. In this stage, people understand the underlying moral purposes that are supposed to be served by law and social customs. When a law in democracy ceases to serve a good purpose, they thus feel the people ought to get active and change the law. Understood in this manner, democracy is seen as a social contract whereby everybody tries constantly to contract a set of law that best serve most people, while protecting the basic right of everybody. Respect for the law and sense an obligation to live by the rules and present. As long as rules were established in fair manner and fulfill a moral purpose, it is said that only about 20 to 25% of today's adults ever reach this stage, and most of those that do supposedly only get there after their mid-20s. The motto here is, I'll live by the rules or try to change them. And lastly, stage 6. Deciding on basic moral principle by which you will live your life and relate to everyone fairly. In this stage, rare people have evaluated many values and have rationally chosen a philosophy of life that truly guides their life. Morally developed, they not automatically conform to tradition or others' belief, and even their own emotion. Institutions are impulsive notions about right and wrong. In stage 6, individual duties choosely elect fundamental principles to follow, such as caring for and respecting everyone living things, feeling that people are all equal and thus deserve equal opportunities, or subscribing to the golden rule. They are though enough to act of their values even if others may think they are odd or is their belief are against man's laws, such as refusing the fight in a war.